India is safe. India is unsafe. Yes and no. The question of safety is subjective, but India is a safe and easy country to travel to, for the most part. I have been traveling across India for more than 1.5 years, hiking to remote places, hitchhiking for months, and experiencing local culture solo. Even though giving tips is irrelevant and this is something you figure out for yourself, I have put together a list of 10 things I myself follow while traveling across India. One of the first and foremost things I have always maintained throughout my 1.5 years of traveling across India is that I always wear a scarf. Because I travel in local buses and trains and I often hitchhike, it's very important for me to always wear a scarf, and I keep it in a way that covers my upper frontal body as much as possible. Now, unless you are in an absolutely safe place, and that is according to your understanding of safety at that point, I would say it's better not to wear something that is attention driven. And I know that is not how it is supposed to be, but that's the way it is in India. So if you're traveling in very remote places in India, it's just nice to wear something local, which I personally prefer. But I also don't like to buy local clothes all the time because I don't really buy a lot of things. So I generally borrow when I'm volunteering there. I borrow something from a local family. And that brings me to the next point, that is, try not to draw too much attention to yourself. It's better to be a little bit inconspicuous in a very offbeat place. Suppose you are hiking on a trail all by yourself, and there is always a chance that you may meet a local, and that local may have some intention, some bad intention. It's possible, even though that particular thing has never happened to me, but it is always possible. So no one can actually guarantee your safety. So when you are hiking all by yourself as a woman, and it's like, sometimes I also feel like I wish I could wear something that is more comfortable. Also have to think of my safety. So I don't always get to wear something comfortable when I'm hiking, particularly if I'm hiking in a trail that is remote and I'm hiking by myself. And this has been said a million times, that your instincts will take you forward, and that is actually 100% true. That is not to say your instincts will always be right. Sometimes you may not understand the true intention of a person, but for the most part, let's say 95 or 96% of times, you are right. So this is a factor that kind of develops the more you travel. This is not something you can learn theoretically. This is something when you're out there, you are meeting these people, you're all by yourself, and you just know how to deal with them. And most of the times you are right. So you always have to listen to yourself. And another aspect to it is that you have you at that moment, and you have yourself to listen to, your experiences, your understanding, and you really have to take that in, because you don't really have an option at that time. And that is something that will teach you to develop this particular skill of understanding, even though it's not exactly a skill. It's just, it can always go wrong, it can always be right, and even then you have yourself. So that is a very strong drive. Now I always keep this with me. This is a paper spray, even though I never really used it. When I'm hitchhiking particularly, I keep the paper spray like this in my hand, and I keep it just by my side. So I don't really have to take it out of my bag. I just have it ready like this. So I intentionally make it conspicuous so that the person knows that I have something. And sometimes I just try to hide it, and if something happens, then I can just do like this. But that I never got to do, even though once I was in a bad situation, only once, when I was hitchhiking in a truck, but I could not really use the paper spray at that time. Now, if you're hitchhiking in India as a solo female traveler, then you should ideally note down the number from the number plate and send it to somebody. And there are a lot of tricks and ways to let the person know, whoever is driving or whoever is in the car, that you have sent the number to somebody. You can just call that person and say, oh, I'm here and, you know, I'm going there, I'll call you when I reach there. Sometimes you can say, you know, somebody is coming to get you, so you don't always have to say that you are alone, which I would highly prefer. That don't, and if a person is asking you, then don't tell that person that you are alone. So you can always say somebody is coming, maybe your friend or your partner or somebody, whoever it is, somebody is coming just behind, and just make up some story. If it's a family, like if a family gives me lift, which almost never happens, then I don't have to really worry that much. But then again, it all depends, you know, you just have to listen to your instincts. And I would say it's so much better not to tell the person that you are alone. I was reading some blogs, some women wear fake rings. Now, since we are on the topic of hitchhiking particularly, I personally have only one rule, which I always maintain. Even though for the most part, I remain kind of tension-free, and that is the whole point. If I'm constantly thinking, would I be in trouble? And then it's just the whole experience is not worth it. So I kind of stay tension-free, but there is one thing I always maintain. So I have a list of places from India, and I kind of follow the number plates. If the car is from that particular region, then I would never ask for lift. Even if that person offers me lift, there were times when people offered me lifts and I really needed one, but then even then I said no. That is not to say that that particular region is always unsafe, but I have my own protocol. I would never accept lifts from cars coming from those particular regions. Now, India is not particularly unsafe, but it just takes one person to change your perspective, right? And so if I'm too late, suppose the train reaches the place after 11 p.m., then I prefer to stay at the railway station, and I prefer not to roam around the city after 10 or 11. 10 is still, like, if I'm new to the city, then it all depends, but mostly 10, no. And that's why I have spent a lot of time at railway stations in Bihar, MP, Rajasthan, because I just reached really late. And just something I always maintain, even if that particular city is maybe particularly safe, I still don't prefer going out at night. And also, if I'm staying at a place for some time, even then, I would roam around that place till 8 maximum, 8 p.m. Or 9 p.m. maximum, 9 p.m. But no, never more than 9. I will always come back. And I will end this with a very short tip. Particularly if you're in a very crowded place, you know, railway stations, places like UP or Kolkata or Bihar, places that are very crowded. What I do is I always keep my hand like this when I'm moving, like as if it's a shield and you can't really touch my upper body. So it's always like this, and it's just not always a good experience to just smear yourself in the sea of humans. And so I always keep my hand like this. So when I'm trying to go forward, I just keep my hand like this.